everyone, I'm Ashley. Welcome back to my GRE How To Series, where we talk about everything we need to know for standardized tests. Today, we're actually going to talk about something that's pretty much applicable no matter which test you're talking about, number properties and the common pitfalls associated with that. Stay tuned. Before we get started, I wanted to send a little love to the people at YouTube after the horrible events this week. I used to work there and I know that every single person in that building is doing everything they can to create amazing creator, user, and partner experiences, and I wanted to let you know that you're doing a great job. Today we're going to be talking about prime numbers and zero and the common pitfalls that people make when it comes to those particular set of numbers. This is going to be really helpful for you in the quantitative sections on the SAT, the GRE, and the GMAT. So I'm glad to have all the people here who are getting ready for those wonderful journeys. At the end of the day, we're all doing these tests for something greater, so let's not lose sight of that. So what is a prime number? Well, a prime number is an integer, which means that it is a whole number, no decimals, no fractions, it's not possible. The second thing to realize about a prime number is that it is a positive number. It's not possible for a negative number to be a prime number. The third thing to realize is that a prime number only has two factors, one and itself. So, is one a prime number? No. Because the only factor in one is one. Okay, so with that logic, is two a prime number? Yes, two is a prime number because the only factors in two are one and two. So it's really important to make sure that you remember that, because I know that I've gone and tests sometimes thinking, oh yeah, I'm gonna count the number of prime numbers. It's 3, 5, 8. Definitely not 8. The whole point is I skip over 2 because I wasn't necessarily conscious about the fact that 2 is a prime number. You're so used to seeing prime numbers as odd numbers, but you forget that number 2 is one of those sneaky primes. So is 0 a prime number? No. 0 is really special because technically it has infinite amounts of factors. 0 times 0 equals 0, 0 times 20 equals 0, 0 times 522,600 is also 0. So that is not a prime number. Now that we're on the topic of 0, I want to bring special attention to that, because zero is one of those sneaky numbers too. So there are 4 things I want you to remember about 0. First, 0 is an integer. It counts as a whole number. Second, 0 is neither positive or negative. So when you get those questions asking about what's a positive or a negative number, 0 is not included in those things. The third thing I want you to remember is that you cannot really divide anything by 0. None of these tests are going to ask you to divide by 0. Definitely remember that. Dividing by 0 is an undefined operation. And fun fact, if you are gonna work with exponents, anytime you're raising anything by 0, it always equals 1. Those are your quick tips for avoiding the common pitfalls with prime numbers and 0. So if this is helpful for you, give me a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it. And don't forget to subscribe. This is built to be a journey for all of us as we are studying for these random standardized tests, and I want it to be something that is enjoyable. Question of the day, what's the most surprising thing you've learned in your study journey so far? Share your answers in the comments below, and I can't wait to hear from you.